Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel and to another Honkai Impact reaction. It's time to react to Siren's battlesuit preview. It's like kind of weird to see Siren becoming a playable character, you know. The last time I saw her was while reading The Second Eruption, and it's been a while since I read that. But yeah, I'm really interested to see her battlesuit preview. And I would say we will start. As always, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and leave a like on the video. And yeah, let's go. Character designer interview. She looks super cute, by the way. The music is nice. Okay, wait, she has a scissors. I didn't even notice. I like that. You know what this reminds me of? Like Dragon Guard 3. In case you don't know that game, it's kind of a Nier game, Nier related. One of them, she has also violet hair and she has also a scissors as a weapon. I liked her. She was crazy in some kind of way, but I liked her. And like Siren reminds, her battle style and everything reminds me of her. A puff of fish.
Mm. 首先，他最初的印象给我感觉是，有着金色瞳孔的一只小猫这种感觉，然后呢，比较标志性的长长的卷发，还有魔法水晶的脚环，总体给你感觉是一种，像孩子一样的俏皮可爱的。Her
dress is really cute.
希林是魔法少女吗？ 我们就在想，魔法少女我们应该做怎样的一个形象会比较好呢？是比较偏高挑一点的呢，还是说我们做的年幼一点？后来也是犹豫了很久，我们采用说做她年纪比较小的这种感觉。当然做出来之后配合她这个跨起脸的这个感觉，还是比较对味的。
说到魔法，难免会想到站桩吟唱。
但是呢，我们希望给希林引入一个魔法阵的概念。我们一开始在设计上就没有给他用一般魔法师用的那种符文去表现，而是采用了星星和剪刀的组合去表现他的魔法。然后希林给我的感觉是一个有点小傲娇，但是又很可爱的小女孩，所以在颜色上也没有采用那种很明亮的颜色，而是采用了饱和度比较偏低一点的紫红色去表现他的那种小性格。
最后我们也是做了各种各样的一些脑洞吧，比如说比人还要大的那种剪刀啊，还有做了一个小小的魔镜啊，这种去补充魔法少女的这个感觉。Oh,
okay. I like that with the scissors.
感觉在游戏里面，如果用剪刀这种武器的话，这个方式应该也挺新奇。有回我在理发的时候，看见理发师。 他这个剪刀在我头上利索的上下飞舞，当时我就在想，这个剪刀能否作为我们这个动画的攻击方式之一呢？因为剪刀嘛，它类似于一种大件，可以挥砍。
True, true. I mean, that scissors is quite
big。增加一些剪的话，那么这个攻击就会变得非常有灵动感。前面两集我们采用了比较轻盈的方式攻击敌人，第三集旋转式狂暴的往下砸。
这个方式能体现他暴娇少女的另外一种性格，砸。这个方式能体现他暴娇少女的另外一种性格。嗯，一群笨蛋。在用剪刀剪掉自己的幼稚之后，他用魔法来缝补自己由于急于成长而变得乱七八糟的心，所以就在江东东给他加入了这种真和线，把敌人围困起来。
嗯，
包括这些像中间吸的这种气流呀，和一些星星点点的魔法。
他可以在战斗中通过各种各样的攻击在场地上画出魔法阵，当魔法阵出现的时候呢，可以点击武器技衔接特殊的魔法攻击。
Her gameplay looks very interesting. 麒麟
可以通过传按持续的蓄力，在蓄力期间可以点燃周围的敌人，并且给予敌人点燃层数，通过不同时间的蓄力呢，可以释放不同等级的蓄力攻击。最后麒麟会释放他的必杀技，将敌人拉入他的魔法空间，并且将敌人封锁在他的魔法镜中，然后利用剪刀给予敌人强力的最后一击。
别乱动了。
Oh, with the mirror. Okay, that's nice.
麒麟就像是青春期的我们，不想被当作小孩子，为此会做出很多很多努力。但恰恰是我们的这些努力，反而让我们看上去并不像是一个成熟的大人。就比如说麒麟头上的两绺像猫耳朵一样的头发，当有人对他的头发表现出兴趣时，他会拼命地遮掩，生怕因为这两个猫耳朵而被当成是幼稚的小孩。但弗洛艾和布洛洛并不会在意这些，相反他们还非常的喜欢，甚至有的时候趁麒麟不注意还会偷偷摸摸他。也许麒麟还要经过很长一段时间才能明白，大家并不会因为一些标签比如说成熟而喜欢他，大家只会因为他是麒麟而喜欢他。
很好，多夸夸我也没关系哦。
Okay, she's very cute. I really like her character design, like with the bandages and stuff like that. That's really, really cool. Yeah, I was kind of surprised when I heard about that she is coming as a battle suit to play, you know, as a playable character. It's like really nice, and I love like the scissors. As I said before, this is a very nice feature to implement like a kind of unique weapon, you know, which is not just the sword. If you want me to check out another battlesuit preview, which I haven't seen, you can do that in the comments down below. I will watch whatever you want to see, which battlesuit you want me to react to. But that's it for now for this reaction. I hope you enjoyed it. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye.